official right now. In 4 minutes or less, we gonna crown all of them right now. My mama, your mama, you, and you. Your baby's mama's mama's mama.
This is dedicated to you.
Wife,
you.
If you're near a woman right now, wherever you at, just turn to him and say,
this is dedicated to you.
You are appreciated.
This is dedicated to
I
you.
I appreciate your smile.
Thank you.
And the how much it take to carry and birth a child.
Thank you.
And the way you play dumb, even when we living real foul.
Ooh, thank you.
And even as a single parent mama, still hold it down somehow.
Thank you, mama.
Make them ends meet somehow.
Thank you, mama.
I appreciate your strength.
Thank you.
Never bite your lip, you say what's on your mind.
Thank you.
You. A lady in the street and a freak when it's bedroom time.
Thank you.
You. Gonna grind with me, roll with me, tell me what's yours is mine.
The best thing I did for our company 2 years ago was put everyone on a calendar. I mean, everyone can see my like everyday things, you know, or I can see what my staff are doing and where we're gonna be at. And so it's pre-planning. Like if you don't know what you're doing tomorrow, that's a fail in life. That's a real thing. And I really can't stand personally, it's a pet peeve of mine when someone says, oh, I'm not sure what I'm doing tomorrow. No. I know what I'm doing tomorrow specifically. I know what I have going on tomorrow. In fact, I know what I have going on the next 5 days. To me, that's success. It means that you're organized. It means that there's key things that you have to do, that you're mentally prepared and you're physically prepared for what you're about to endure in the next few days.
One thing I learned being a woman, unfortunately, is that they see you before they hear you. So what happened was, Alicia, a long time ago, wasn't too long ago, but I was out here balancing 15 million jobs. And your girl, I did not know much about beauty, skincare, and maintenance just because I was on the court. The next, you know, I was in the studio. So I just got caught slipping, like literally slipping, like hairline slipping on television, okay? And let me tell you, the day it went viral, I thought my life was going to end. I was like, I'm going to forever be that girl with the bad hair on television. So I go on and talk and be like, oh, there go the girl with my hairline, you know what I'm saying? And that was just because they didn't see the behind the scenes. They didn't see me grinding in practice for a week straight, 4 hours of driving an hour and a half to go in studio, or not even being educated on beauty and wellness. And so I go on TV and that's the thing they see. Thank God it lasted only 24 hours. And thank God that taught me how to get my weave slayed. But God, you know what I'm saying? But like, without going through that situation of the negatives, I didn't discover what I needed to do so I could make everything else a positive.
And a grown woman knows how to tell you no. A grown woman knows when to let you go. You can have a big old car and a big old house, but next to God, nothing else amounts to a woman,
woman, woman, strong woman.
Y'all, I've never had this experience before with NeverLeveled's on paint, and I'm telling you, it was so much fun. I mean, I walked in and they were playing my Afro beats. It's like they knew I was coming, you know what I'm saying? I am the worst painter, but I had the best.